This is rag jog, somewhat similar to natai. There is a slight difference, but more or less the same.
Thank you.
Friends, I am very happy to have participated in the 5-day long music festival held in the memory of the great legend Chaudhayaji. As an extension to the concert yesterday, I am here to present a brief lecture demonstration. The subject that I am choosing is appreciation of Hindustani music, a concert of Hindustani music. I'm a little unhappy about one thing. Such, you know, concerts you keep having, and concerts are organized every now and then. You get opportunities to listen to a full-fledged concert, but lecture demonstrations where one gets to learn about the intricacies of the subject are rare. So I would have been happier if there had been more students. Anyway, I'm happy that at least some teachers are there. You can pass off the information to them later on. As I told you, I'm taking up the most popular form of composition in Hindustani music. You might have heard about forms such as Dhrupad, Dhamar, Khyal, Thumri, Tappa. Among all of them, the most popular form is the Khyal form of composition. Dhrupad singers are far and few between, whereas there are umpteen number of Khyal singers. The word Khyal, the term Khyal means imagination, Khyal. In our day-to-day parlance, we use such phrases as Mere Khyal Se. Mere Khyal Se means Mere Vichar Se. Khyal revolves around one's imaginative skill. One has to be highly imaginative in order to render a khyal. I'll tell you how. The khyal composition, the compositions as such are very short. The composition would take hardly a minute or a minute and a half. I'll play the composition first. There are vilambit khyals, which are slow khyals. There are madhyalai khyals, which are medium tempo khyals. And there are drut khyals as well. Today I'm taking up a madhyalai khyal. The procedure is the same for vilambit khyal also. So I'll first explain what a madhyalai khyal is, how it is rendered. I'll play the Madhyalai Khyal has two parts. The first part is called Sthai. The second part is called Antara. Normally, Sthai has two lines and Antara also has two lines. The composition is rendered first. I'll play the composition for you and you will yourself see it gets over in a very short while. The rag is Bairagi. I think it's the same as Revati of Carnatic music. I'll play the composition alone. I'll play the composition without the rhythmic accompaniment and then explain about the rhythmic part and then play with the tabla later. The first line is Sthai goes like this. The first line of Sthai is ... repeated twice. The second line. Second line is over. After playing the first line and second line, in other words, the sthayi, we go back to the first line of sthayi. Then comes the antara, first line of antara. Again. Second line. Sthayi and antara, we go back to the sthayi. Now, I'll play this along with taal. The taal on which this composition is set is called teen taal. Teen taal has 16 beats, 16 counts. I'll request him to play the taal for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. We don't get the numbers out from the tabla. We have specific syllables. They are called theka. The theka goes as dha, thin, thin, dha, dha, thin, thin, dha, dha, thin, thin, ta, ta, thin, thin, dha, dha, thin, thin, dha, dha, thin, thin, dha, dha, thin, thin, ta, ta, thin. Now, the song commences from the ninth beat. I'll play the composition for you. Second line. First line. Antara. Again. Second line. Again. Back to sthayi. I'll play the compositions once again without talking in between so that you will know how, what exactly is the duration taken. जरा बढ़ा दीजिए इतना नहीं Composition is over. The khyal is over. Now,
Before I proceed explaining what happens when the once the composition gets over, I'll have to tell you a little about the starting phrase of the composition. The starting phrase is again. This is called the mukhda. The initial phrase is called mukhda. Mukhda has its importance of its own. Why, I'll tell you. The mukhda has to be kept in mind throughout the rendering by the listener. Because during the elaboration of the khyal, the mukhda is played again and again. So I'll once again play the mukhda for you. And the mukhda starts from the ninth beat and mukhda ends on the first beat. First beat is called the sum or the beginning point of the tala round. You know, when you take the mukhda and arrive at the sum, it gives a pleasant experience. You feel like marking the tal yourself. I'll play the mukhda once or twice. Somebody remember jaiye. Aha, pacha. Da din din da da din din. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again. मैं बजाती हूँ, आप मत बजाइए. मैं जब सम पे आऊँगी, उस समय सम आप अच्छी तो वहाँ से धा दिन दिन तक शुरू कीजिए, ताकि मैं जो कह रही हूँ, वो लोगों को अच्छी तरह समझ में आएगा. मैं बजाती हूँ, लुकिए, मैं बजाऊँगी, मैं सब सम पे आऊँगी, तब आप बजाइए. Again. I hope you have understood what I mean. Mukhda is very important. The listener should be able to identify the mukhda. Now, once the composition gets over, what is done is the elaboration of the raga is taken up. Here, it is different from Carnatic music. In Carnatic music, once the song starts, once the kriti starts, there is no place for alapana. It is not usually done like that. Alapana is done prior to the kriti. I'll tell you how it is done. I'll play the mukhda and then I'll take up the alap. Now composition is over. Aap jaate hain. The tal keeps on. He continues to play all the 16 beats continuously. Now the elaboration starts. We take up one note and making use of the adjacent notes, elaborate it. Try to think as many combinations and permutations as possible. For instance, take a note, elaborate it for a short while, then bring it to a beautiful end. By that time, he would be on the ninth matra. You take the mukhda. You start the alap right from the lower notes, sa, and then go to the next note, re, then re, ma. This rag takes sarima panisa. So one by one, you proceed further and then render alaps. I'll play a few alaps, one or two, just to drive home the point how mukhra is important. So I played one alap on sa, now this was on ma, I'll play one on top sa. After the alap gets over, I'll take the mukhra. When we are playing in the higher octave, when we finish the alap, we finish it on the top sa, and then we take the antara mukhra. Antara. We'll do some more alaps on the higher octave. Every time after the alap, we'll take the antara mukhra. We'll do a concluding alap. We'll start from the one of the higher notes and slowly come back to the lower octave. At that time, we'll take the sthayi mukhra only. So this is, raga is developed in three stages. In a khyal, the raga is developed in three stages. The first stage is called alap. We play the composition, then we play the alaps, one after the other, then take the mukhra, and we use our creative skill while elaborating the raga. Now, when I am playing, he will just be repeating the theka, that cycle of 16 beats. In between, you know, I do my improvisations, my imaginative work. Similarly, he also gets chances to improvise on his own. When he does this improvisation, I will be repeating the same line over and over again. You will have an example of that also. Now, he gets a chance now.
Aap abhi bajaiyega, main. एक कोई बजा के संपर्क आइए.
does his improvisation and then comes and joins on the sum. Just as I played the mukhra and come on the sum, he also does the same thing, but it's all rhythmic improvisations. So this is all about the first stage of raga elaboration. Once the ala portion gets over, we switch over to what is called boltan. I'll play a boltan and then I'll explain about it. That was a boltan. After a boltan also, we take the mukhra. Now what is a boltan? Here again it is my own imagination, my own improvisation. In what way is it different from the alap? While doing the alap, you will have a feeling that it has nothing to do with the tal. It's only when you take the mukhra, it gets connected to tal. Whereas while playing the boltan, every note is, there is rhythm in that. The same phrase, if it is played, it's all up. I'll pick. Now boltan. Also, boltan also, we start from the sa, madhya saptak sa, go note after note, re, ma, pa, ni. I'll play 2, 3. I played on sa, now I'll play on pa. One more in sa, on sa, top sa. Now, it's not necessary that a boltan should, the whole thing should be based on rhythm. You can start with alap, switch on to boltan, come back to alap. It's up to you, whatever you feel like. See an example. Din din da da, din din da da din. This is all alap. How important mukhra is, unless you follow the mukhra. You know, down south, many people say, we are unable to understand what is happening on the stage, everything is slow, and they will understand if they know that there is a mukhra to be followed. I'll tell you about the Vilambit Khyal also once I finish with this. Now, the third stage of raga elaboration is Tan, where notes are rendered in a quick pace. I play the Tan without tabla. After every Tan, we take the Mukhda. This is how a khyal is developed. The composition takes a minute. Thereafter, it is up to you. If you are allotted half an hour time, you can carry on for half an hour with one khyal. If it is 15 minutes, curtail the number of alafs, curtail the number of boltan, tan, lesser number of tans, and then there it gets over. This is how, and the tablist also keeps getting opportunities for showing his rhythmic skill, his imaginative skill. You know, this teen tal can be compared to the Carnatic Adi tal, because it's here it is 16 beats, whereas it is 8 there, two rounds of. In a Vilambit Khyal, things are slightly different in the sense. The essentials are the same, Mukhda, sum, and then again ala, Mukhda, bolta. But the tal is very slow. One of the tals is Ektal. Ektal has 12 matras. I'll ask him to play in a faster speed now. Dhin dhin dhage terakita tu na katta dhage terakita dhina. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2. But in a Vilambit Khyal, it is played, one has four divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9. So that's how it goes. So for one round, it takes easily 1 minute. I'll play the Mukhda. Thoda sa aur vilambit kar lena. 1, 2. Bade nahi. 3, 4. It goes. On the 12th matra, I'll take the Mukhda. And then the Mukhda ends on the first matra. Nahi, aap to udhar hi jaiye. Aage ka, la, dhe, ge, ye aakhir ka. Ge, te. This is 10. 11. Now the Mukhda comes on 12. For that one full round, we We play the alap. We are coming to 10 now. I'll slowly finish off the alap. 11. So, one thing we artists have to know the theka. We must memorize the theka. We should be able to know where exactly he is. After certain practice, even without looking, I can tell where he is. He is in seventh or sixth or whatever it is, without even looking to him or looking to his hands. Here again, the khyal is just 1 minute only. And sthai is one round, antara is another round. There the khyal gets over, then it is alap. Alap, you can imagine how long it will take. Even one round of alap is 1 minute. You take sa re ma pa one by one. Right by the time you reach, and sometimes we do two alaps or three alaps at one place. There is more masala to render. So by the time we reach the top sa, it is easily half an hour. Finish off the alap, come down, then do a few boltans. Say 5 minutes or so, then do a few tans, and the bada khyal gets over there, and then we switch over to madhyalai khyal, and that's how a program raga is elaborated in khyal style. Whereas in Drupal, the alap is rendered elaborately before the composition, just as it is done in Carnatic music. In khyal, the alap is mixed up along with the, so that's why some people are wondering why this tabla is going on and we are not able to make head or tail of what is happening. So this is what it is. Now you can pass on this information to your students. In case you have any questions, I would welcome. You have a question?
Sabhikru, Dr. N. Rajam avaralli prashneyana kelbodu. Kannadadalle kelbodu, naan tarjume maadi avarige
helthe. I hope all of you understood what I said, you know.
Madam, I have a question.
Yeah. Go ahead.
In Carnatic music, how good an instrumentalist is judged based upon how much of vocal style he manages to incorporate. So all our compositions have a sahitya. In the Hindustani tradition, there are these pure instrumental compositions. While in Carnatic music, we cannot imagine a pure instrumental composition without a sahitya for it, even though there are a few recent attempts. When did this tradition of pure instrumental compositions come into being, and since when did the pure instrumental compositions start? And what is their importance, what is their significance in the instrumental tradition in the Hindustani music?
Yeah. You know what, when we say khyal, it automatically means it is vocal composition. There are words, there is a sahitya. What happens is, in the north, there are instruments, plucked instruments, like sitar, sarood. Before that, let me tell you one more thing. In Carnatic music, there is no separate style for instruments. Whatever the instrument may be, flute, violin, veena, whatever it is, everybody plays only the vocal. It's all vocal only. There is no special instrumental style as such. Whereas in the north, there is a separate style for instruments, because some of the instruments are so made. For instance, sitar, you pluck it, within a few seconds, the sound dies down. So a phrase which requires, you know, a long breath, such phrases are not possible. Whereas in vocal music, music means you get continuity with your breath, you have continuity of tone. So any phrases can be rendered. Whereas on instruments like sitar, sarod, there are limitations. Keeping in mind the limitations of such instruments, a style was evolved in due course of time there. That's called gatkari. For instance, I'll show the difference between my style and the gatkari. What is the difference between a gat? I'll play. It is normally played like this. On curtain. For instance, this is the first line of a gat. Here the syllables are dara, 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 something like that. Whereas the same thing, if it is to be rendered in gaiki style, the style which I have adopted, at places I am asked to differentiate between gatkari and gaiki. I played certain tans now, no? Tans, how are they played in gatkari style? Now the same thing in vocal. Otherwise, that's how over a period of time gatkari got formed or evolved. For instance, a raga like Miamalar. Unless it is vocal, it's simply not possible. Another example, say, Hamir. See that Gamadha. Otherwise, that's how it is played. And violin being a bowed instrument, it's very easy to get continuity of tone. You can play the bow for any length of time, see. Any length of time, till it only requires a little control. So any vocal phrase is possible on the violin if you have the right technique. And any day, vocal music appeals more. Yeah, I think we will. It's getting late. We have a program in the evening also. We'll put an end to it here.
In requesting for a small piece performance.
Okay. I'll play a light piece. This is in Kamaj. It's called a dadra. It's a Banarasi dadra. It's in a tal called dadra, having 6 beats. Yeah.